That's right, Jen. Oliver is in quarantine at the police department until his shot records are reviewed. But police say since the dog was leashed and on his own property, no charges are anticipated. Oliver's owners have promised not to bring him back to the neighborhood and are debating selling their townhouse and moving so they can keep the dog they so dearly love.
This is Oliver, a little unsure about our camera and his surroundings. He's been locked in this kennel since Sunday when he did this to 6-year-old Sarah Stewart.
And then I slipped on the leash, and then I fell on the dog Oliver, and then he started attacking me.
I heard my wife saying, Greg, you gotta grab her, take it to the hospital. And I didn't know, I just saw the trail of blood just running from where she was to the car.
Oliver's owners are horrified. They say Oliver was startled when Sarah tripped, reaching for a bottle of bubbles.
Yeah, because he was sitting and she went flying on top, and he did what a dog would do. A cat would do it, you know, but we aren't going to bring him back here at all. We will respect the neighborhood, and we'll respect Debbie and Greg, and we don't want Sarah to ever be afraid of him.
The Stewarts say they're very friendly with the Palmieris, but weren't happy when they brought this particular breed to their compact neighborhood and made a family rule about staying away when Oliver was out.
But I mean, in the neighborhood with a bunch of kids, I just couldn't see a pit bull living in a complex, a condo association, or anywhere with kids. It's just, it's tough. It's, those dogs turn on anybody.
So what do you think? What do you think about Oliver?
I don't like him.
Did you like Oliver before?
No.
Oliver does have a record. He bit another dog in the neighborhood, but his owners adore him and say he is wonderful around their grandchildren and their German Shepherd, Kendra.
Heartbreaking.
Yeah. Sarah's teacher and principal stopped by today with flowers and cards from the school. No word on when Sarah might be well enough to return to school. Her parents say she'll go back for plastic surgery once that wound is healed. Live in the studio, Amy Covino, WMUR News 9.